Robert Boyce, the chief of detectives, the New York Police Department, said that on Sunday afternoon, they interviewed Shanika Nicole Thompson. She is known to be the ex-girlfriend of Brinsley. The two have known each other for about a year, so they're hoping to get some more information from her about his motivation for all of this. Now, what we do know about Thompson is that she lived here in this apartment complex alone, although Brinsley had a key that he wasn't supposed to have, and he entered her apartment at 5:30 a.m. on Saturday morning. He wasn't supposed to enter. She challenged him on that. The two had an argument. He came in anyway. She called her mother, who heard part of that argument, and then he fired a shot into Thompson's stomach, grabbed her phone, and fled. Well, listen here to what happened next.
At about 6:05 in the morning, he calls the mother on her phone, the girlfriend's mother on the phone, and he says he shot her by accident and that he hopes she lives. He then, at 6:35 hours, Baltimore County Police Department begins monitoring his movements, and they have him tracked going northbound on I-95. During this time, he calls his girlfriend's ex-girlfriend's mother several times and goes through, makes certain statements that we're able to find out where he's going.
Now, from Baltimore police, we know that at about 1:30 on Saturday, one of Thompson's friends called police to warn them about Brinsley's Instagram feed because he had made some threats to law enforcement. Baltimore police then called New York police about 2:10 to warn them about those threats. And then the New York police say that at about 2:50, they got a fax with a wanted flyer with Brinsley's image on it. But of course, as we know, that was just a few minutes too late. Erin McPike, CNN, Owings Mills, Maryland.